Hello everyone, this is Fenris Lycon. Of course, that's Shadow. We're here for another game of Surviving Mars. Let's get this going. We're about to go into another cold wave. And I did play around with the oval dome. Oof, my voice. And I think right here is going to be a good one. I'm going to end up moving these metal deposits. But we'll be able to hit both this metal and rare metal, and this rare metal is one of the anomaly ones, which got us 1,000 very high deposit. We can't hit this vista, but if we put another dome here, we could, and maybe that dome will end up being our manufacturing dome. This one will probably be, and then we'll have like a secondary one, and we should be able to put a tunnel here and then to here, and we'll have like kind of a, I doubt we'll ever put a dome down here, but we can definitely hit this water, and then we'll have maybe like solar panels, batteries, a whole bunch of like storage of water and oxygen. And okay, before I forget on this cold wave, let's definitely turn on the heater. Because missing that hurts so bad. We lose all of our kind of stored water. I'll also send the rocket off. We do need more machine parts. Oop. Okay. We can take one off of you. And wait. Where? Get assigned to here. Okay, and have we rescued? Yes, we've rescued our explorer. It doesn't look like there's any anomalies. So we'll bring both of them over. You. Nope, it's you. You can come over here. Are we all set for the cold wave? Yes. Once the cold wave hits, we'll probably have to turn a bunch of things off at night. And we're kind of refilling everything after that, the dust storm. It's kind of unfortunate that we've the maintenance on this. We won't be able to run this at during the cold wave, so we'll turn that off. Yeah, we have two water towers we can't use. Alright, I did turn on our farm, and we actually have a lot of unemployed. Now the question is, do we turn on a rare metals extractor, or do we turn on our polymers? Do we actually have the power, is the other question. Do we need any kind of meat shopping? Think, and this is, we don't really need the comfort, but I think it long term, a grocer in this one. This one really kind of lacks a lot of service buildings, but it does have a lot of parks, so we'll put a grocer, and that will actually use all of our unemployed, and once we get a few more, we can kind of think about what to do with them, and we have the options of both the polymer factory and the rare metals. What's really nice is we made it up to over 100 polymers. That's what's required for the oval dome. We currently look very good.
Research complete.
During the day. So we have our electronics factory.
Sector scanned. Anomaly found. Nice.
Have you go over here. Ooh, another breakthrough. I love looking at breakthroughs. They're like the exciting part. You see all the technologies normally. Breakthroughs are what makes a map. And I know kind of they're known by the map, but I really haven't looked closely at them. I checked the beginning few because those are the ones, like I said, the first 28 souls are kind of the make or break of a colony. So I checked like the first two or three out. I don't remember what the later ones are, which is what we're going into. Ooh. Full there, and we're full there. So we are
Resources are
completely
low.
using our medical resources up. I think well actually, especially because we have extra people, I'm gonna change this medical post out for an infirmary. And this is like, I think, kind of a big part of as you expand, repurpose your domes. You might have to r really rework them, but we'll kind of, I think, a few times, like in my future plan, we'll probably get rid of the space bar and put in a security post if we end up putting apartments here. I could see apartments, two apartments here, and a like a machine parts or electronics here, and maybe we put the small a small space bar here. I was actually kind of my like when I first put these two domes down, thinking a full size space bar would be here. I think that's ultimately why I didn't end up naming this small space bar as like a distillery or anything. Because I was like, oh, I'll do that once we put the large space bar in the Niels Windahl dome. But I think we're gonna run out of space. So we'll have the actual like nice space bar in our oval dome, which is Andersonville. We already have the name for it. Right, we have this, turn that on. We'll remove our medical post. How do we look? We have one extra space for workers and eight for residents. And actually, we look really good with power. We're positive at night. Is there anything we can turn on? Oh, sorry, this is the evening.
Breakthrough discovered.
Nice. Let's check that breakthrough out. Magnetic extractors produce increase by 50. That's pretty strong. It's unfortunately very expensive. I think I'm gonna leave it blank right now. We have 3,000 research queued up already. And I'll speed things up. So we just go. Okay, we're only 11. I'll turn the oxygen on at night. We have the spare power. In fact, we have the spare power to run the rare metals extractor. I think that's kind of decides it. The next shift, especially if we're going to do it
Sector
during a cold
scanned.
wave, will
Anomaly
be the rare
found.
metals solely because it takes less power and water. We have to pay water for the polymer factory, but it definitely feels good to have a large stockpile. And of course, this rocket almost at Earth, it's going to bring more machine parts, which might be what like we put machine parts
Funding
here.
received.
I think it ends up being a little bit funny that the place that produces rare metals will produce the machine parts, and the place that could mine metals will end up producing electronics. And they'll have to be trade, but we'll have that. We have the shuttle. I think I'm just gonna do 45 machine parts. We will be. I like to have 100 million in the bank for events. We kind of got lucky in the last episode for our events. They were both pretty meh. Like, they didn't really do a lot. We lost our like RC commander for a while, but we got what, 10 souls of research?
Breakthrough
Totally
discovered.
worth it. Ooh, another one. Ooh, I would argue this is a very strong one. All colonists gain plus 20 performance during night shifts. So it's almost like having them on with the overwork turned on. But you don't want that on the night shift. You normally turn it off. It's unfortunately very expensive. I think the scrubbing is probably out of everything right now the one I want next, especially because we have a lot of money and a lot of electronics, and we can start putting down, say, our drum hub, our shuttle hub, which we need. That's kind of the idea of getting that. Why am I not putting that first? I'm doing the supercomputing. Just we'll get it eventually. The sooner we get it, the sooner it ends up paying it for itself. I can see a lot of arguments going like, put it off, especially the scrubber's really strong. But I don't know. This is kind of one of the things, like, if you can get something that helps over the long term, get it as soon as possible. That one, it ends up being a little awkward because it's very expensive, so it takes a long, long time to pay for itself. Especially when we during the disasters, because we don't really have a
Sector
huge
scanned.
amount of power surplus during cold or, ooh, oh
A
no.
colonist just snapped.
Okay. This is kind of why I don't think I have any workload increased, because during the disasters they lose it, and this is why we put the infirmary down. It's very easy during the disasters, working at night, working outside, although we haven't turned any of those on, for someone to lose. Yeah, so this guy's working outside. He lost. Wow, 23 and 15 for the just the cold wave. Yeah, we're completely filled up on the infirmary. This is also another kind of good reason to put in the security stations. Security stations do two things. They do renegades, which we're going to always have, but they also reduce the sanity loss from disasters. That's very strong. We also do not have the research that reduces sanity loss to Martian born. That would also be a very strong one for us. Let's speed things up. And sorry, I also purposely didn't was okay going under 100 million, because I knew we still have our celebrity, our aging celebrity, to boost us up. Thank you, Purvis Gaming, getting us secured. And we're almost through the cold wave. In fact, we actually need to send the rocket back right away. Why do we have unemployed and homeless people when we have open slots?
Meteor shower
Okay, they need
incoming.
to work around. We had a shift, it looks like. It was six vacant people. We had a lot of people, it looks like, aged out. Yeah, we had a lot of people who aged out. Let's see. We haven't. We even have seniors in this one when they're prioritized on this one, which
Anomaly
might be why
found.
we had the aging. And we had some renegades still concrete. That's fine. We're producing a lot of concrete. And they stole polymers. Okay, guys, you can chill out. We don't need you don't need to steal everything from our colony. What are you doing with those resources? You're building your own dome. That.
Resources are low.
They are low, but we have a big rocket. Well, we have a big
breakthrough
load.
Discovered.
Ooh. Ooh. Wow. Oh my goodness. Okay. This is an exciting one. Because with the AI supercomputing, more power means more research. But we do have the opportunity to do the artificial sun. It's kind of expensive research-wise, but those combined means we're safe on power, so cold waves don't matter anymore. And we're going to fly through technology. So this makes it very, very much more tempting. The other thing too, this artificial sun, yes, it takes a lot of resources, but it takes a lot of resources in which we have concrete, metal, polymers. Those are all things produced on Mars right now. This is probably one of the ones we're more capable of actually doing. And with that, and landing this rocket, I think that's where we'll leave off on this episode. So thank you very much for joining us on another episode of Survive to Mars. And I think we're almost out of the... If we're thinking about building Wonder, we might not be pioneers anymore. We might need a nice fancy hat soon. So I'll see you all guys in the future. Friend of Lycon and Shadow signing out.